Guten Morgen, alle Guten. Ich bin dann der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. Now, in this lesson, you will learn the three most important rules of the Luxemburgisch sentence structure. Now, indeed, I have noticed that many students are struggling with the word order in Luxemburgisch sentences. So, in this lesson, I will as well only concentrate on simple sentences. And this lesson is actually part of my upcoming online course called The Basics of the Luxembourgish Sentence Structure. Now, are you ready to learn the three most important rules? Ja, bist du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! Here is the first rule. The verb is always the second element of your sentence. Now, this is the most important rule of the Luxembourgish sentence structure. For example, you can say, Ösch lehren haut Letzburgisch. So you have Ösch, the subject, lehren is your verb, and then the rest, haut Letzburgisch. But you can as well say, haut lehren Ösch Letzburgisch. So you start with haut, this is your time, and then you put your verb followed by the subject. Haut lehren ösch Letzburgisch. So literally you have today learn I Luxembourgish. Now I said that the verb is the second element. So this means that the verb is not the second word, but the second element. For example, you can start your sentence with Hauten Ovent lehren ösch Letzburgisch. So you have three words, Hauten Ovent, but this is the position one because it's when. So when do you learn Luxembourgish? Hauten Ovent. And then you put your verb, lehren, ösch, Letzburgisch. Yes? Okay? So the most important rule is the verb second element in your sentence. Second rule is time, manner, place. So this means that in Luxembourgish we put first the element of time. So you have to ask the question when. In Luxembourgish this is veni. And then the manner, you have to ask the question how, this is ve. And the place, you have to ask the question where, and this is in Luxembourgish wo. For example, in English you would say Tom is coming home by train today. So you have Tom is coming home. Home is the place. By train is the manner, and the time today. Okay? But in Luxembourgish, it's the other way around. We would say, Tom is coming today by train home. So you would have, den Tom kommt heute mam Zug heim. In Luxembourgish, you have first the time, haut. So haut, you have to ask the question, veni, den Tom kommt haut, mam Zug. That's the manner. So how does he come home? Mam Zug. And him is the place. So where? Okay? Now over to you. How would you say in Luxembourgish, I go to work by car every day? Hopefully you've got Ich gehe all day mam Auto op Dabest. Now you see here you have the other way around. We say Ich gehe alldag. Alldag is your time element. Mam Auto, that's the manner. And then op Dabest is your place. And you still have your verb second element. And now we will have the last most important rule, which I will simplify. The third most important rule is the one I call sentence bracket. Now, this is a more complicated rule, and I will go more in depth in my online course, The Basics of the Luxembourgish Sentence Structure. And here I will try to simplify this. So in Luxembourgish, you can have in one sentence an separable verb like hinfahren, where hin is the separable prefix and fahren is the verb. You can as well have in a sentence a modal verb like wollen, können, which require a second verb. And you have as well, like in English, sentences where you have two verbs, for example, to build the present perfect. Okay, then in Luxembourgish, the conjugated verb still remains the second element. For example, meng mam fiert normalerweise 6 Uhr heim. So you have fiert is the conjugated verb, and then you have the separable prefix which comes at the very end of the sentence, and in between this is called the sentence bracket. Now let's have an example with a modal verb. For example, meng mam will all dag 6 Uhr heim fahren. So here you have the modal verb will, which is the conjugated verb, and heimfahren, the second verb, comes at the very end of the sentence. And in between you have all the other elements. Or you can as well use a sentence in the present perfect. For example, meng mam as haut 6 Uhr heim gefuhr. So you see the conjugated verb is still second position, and the second verb here is this the past participle heimgefuhr comes at the very end of the sentence. Easy, isn't it? Summarize what you have learned today. The first rule is the verb is always the second element. Second rule, in a normal sentence you have time, so when, manner, so how, and the place, so where. Okay? And the third rule is when you have in a sentence a separable verb or a modal verb or tenses, then the conjugated verb always is the second element and the second verb comes at the very end of the sentence. And now I invite you to practice what you have learned in this lesson by going to my blog luxembourgishwithanne.lu, and under this lesson you can download the first lesson for free with exercises of my upcoming online course The Basics of the Luxembourgish Sentence Structure. I hope that this lesson was useful and that you will want to learn more about the Luxembourgish sentence structures, for example, in subordinate clauses, so in sentences where there are two parts of a sentence. Great! Merci fürs Zugucken. Thank you for watching.